So everyone, so in this video I'm going to show you how to convert the value specified in the column to integer, and or other words, to solve the problem type error cannot convert to numeric. So that's the main reason. If you perform any mathematical operations on a non-numeric value, this type error will be occur. So let's solve this now. So first let me open a table over here. So let me name it as import pandas first. Okay, import pandas as p. Okay, so a equal to, I already have a CSV file name car, so p dot read underscore CSV. So it's going to be car dot CSV. So now let me open it. So yeah, and run. So you can see here. So this one, I'm now, if I try to find the mean of the last column price, it will definitely show an error. Price dot mean. So it shows a multiple number of errors, except value error, something complex errors, some, and finally we get our error. Could not convert to numeric these values. So for that we need to convert this one into an, where is that, table. So you need to convert the table into a, especially the last row in, to convert the last column into a integer value. So let's do that in this program. So for that we will use str.replace function, and let me do it. So first we'll do a, like we need to be very careful with the syntax, a price the exact name of the column without any change in price. Even if you put small p, the name will get shown error. Dot str dot replace PLACE, open this, single quotes, square bracket, and a comma and a double quote. So okay, so you can ask me, what are this, why these two arguments, what are these arguments? So first the left hand side argument, this one corresponds to the, what are the symbols that are to be removed from the all the values present in the column. So in this case we are going to remove dollar and the comma sign. Even comma affects the value, so only I'm doing this. So it can affect, I don't know if that is completely separate, but dollar affects the value. So we are going to remove the dollar and comma sign from there, and we are going to replace the two symbols with nothing. So this is a blank, it does not even have space. You can see it, we are probably removing it completely without replacing anything. So that what means, if you put some value here, that value will get replaced in the place of this dollar. So now we are going to add the dollar and comma symbol over here. So we are going to add like this slash dollar separated by this slash left hand slash and the comma. So this will remove the dollar and slash present in it. So we will assign this to our column itself so that it changes in the main table, otherwise equal to, okay, that's good. So now it's good, it will change if the dollar and comma will be changed, but still there is a problem. If we do the following things, we will get remove dollar and comma, but these values will be stored in a form of string. Okay, so we can't do our function. So let me show you your demo. If you now print a and run, you can see here perfectly it has changed everything. 4000, 5000, 7000. We have removed the dollar and comma symbol over here. So now let me show you a quick demo. Oh, it's still not an integer, it's a string actually. Let me show you the proof. Now if you perform sum of all the values present in the last column with the price, okay. Price. Okay, it's going to be price dot sum. Okay. You will be shocked to see the result over here. Run means. So look at that. 4000, 5000, 7000, 22000, it's performing the concatenation option plus. So if you perform str plus cat, it will give str cat. That's what's happening here. So this is a wrong thing that happens. So this is wrong. So we need to add, we are still more not yet completed this line. So it's going to be dot as as type. So this is the necessary line. If you miss this line, the entire thing is going to fail. So now we are going to print a and run it. So it's still the same thing, no changes. but it has our data type has changed from string to variable. So if we find sum now, price dot sum, if you run it, look at that, you are getting the sum. And if you find mean also, it will work perfectly. Mean and run. So it works perfectly. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, and more such Python tutorials, kindly subscribe and